All right, so now let's continue further and look at problem 11. And this one states, find the sum of the series, so the summation from n equals 2 to infinity of ln of 1 minus 1 over n squared. All right, so now let's go over the solution. So let's try to simplify this series. And what we can do is, well, let's just simplify this. So we get ln, I'm going to take this, the inside terms. So ln of 1 minus 1 over n squared, and multiply top and bottom by n squared, so that we get a ln of n squared. So n squared minus 1 over n squared. And now we could apply the log rule. Remember this one, when you have a division, this is the same as a subtraction. So this is ln n squared minus 1 minus ln n squared. And this is a, yeah, this is a, this is a log rule right here. So log rule, put it better, logarithmic rule or ln rule. In this case, natural log. Same thing, so log rule. All right, so now that we have this, and then what we could do here, we could do this another log rule, and that is by, well, looking at this setup here, and then writing this out here. I'll just say, yeah, let's put it here. So note that because it's n squared minus 1, so that has some cancellations. In other words, if you had an n plus 1, we'll put it here. N plus 1 times it by n minus 1 when you expand this out. So n times n times n times negative 1. And then the same thing on the bottom. So what you're going to get is a n squared plus, I mean, n times negative 1 is minus n. And then here n 1 times n. So here 1 times n is going to be plus n, and then 1 times negative 1, so minus 1. So these cancel. This equals to negative n squared minus 1. So whenever you have a squares like that, so n squared and 1, 1 is the same thing as 1 times 1 is squared. It's just 1 squared. So when we have that, these cancel out, so we could write it as that, as this setup. So this means that we have, so this equals to, equals to ln of, instead of n squared minus 1, we get n plus 1 times it by n minus 1. And this is a ln of all that. So ln, just put a giant bracket. And then minus ln, and then also another log rule, the 2 goes down. So 2 go ln n, like that. And this is another log rule. And then this becomes right here. This whole setup equals to ln of, so when you have a multiplication, becomes a addition. So that's a useful thing about logarithmics. So ln n minus 1, and also another log rule all the way across here. So then, so this log rule, this breaks it down into this right here. So that's another log rule. Let's put another arrow. So these are all just log rules. And then minus 2 ln n, like that. And another trick is, again, the solutions manual has a pretty next level trick. So this negative 2 ln n, just break that down into negative ln n minus ln n. So just separate that out. And now we're going to combine this to use ln rules. So I'm going to take this. Yeah, I'm going to have this for each one of these. And notice there's a n plus 1 is an n minus 1. All right, so what we'll do here now, again, this is why it's problems plus, because this is very hard to grasp unless you're an absolute expert. So let's say we have ln n minus ln of n minus 1 and then subtract by ln n. We'll group that together, and we'll group this and this together, so this and this one and this one. All right, so what we'll have is this equals to ln of n minus 1 minus ln n. I'm going to put this close brackets, meaning separate from the others. So that's this one right here. And now the other one is going to be, I'm going to subtract so that we have, yes, we have it similar so that the higher a number, n plus 1, is at the bottom. Notice here's n minus 1 is first, n is one smaller, or I mean is one bigger. So that's at the bottom. That's on the right side. And then we're going to be dividing it using log rules. And then this is n plus 1. This is n. And we're going to have this first. This one second, because that's bigger. So this is going to be subtracted out. So we can factor out the negative. So this becomes first. Ln n minus ln n plus 1. And the reason is, again, if you've seen this as you go through this video, telescoping sum is one of the most useful stuff ever. So this equals 2. So then put it all together. Let's put it this here. So thus, ln of 1 minus 1 over n squared is equal to, and again, using log rules, bring it down. This becomes ln of division. So when your subtraction becomes a division, n minus 1 over n, like that. And then minus this part right here, ln of n over n plus 1. Bold this. And put an arrow here. This one goes on this side here. Put that there. All right, yeah, so basically this, of course, looks like we have another telescoping sum, and we could see that as we continue on this. So if this is the series, let's go to the partial sum, and since we already have n, a whole bunch of n's there, in this particular one, they just let the k's partial sum equals to the summation up to k, starting from n equals 2, and again, it just shows you different ways of solving it. You could either put I equals 2 up to n, etc. So we'll just do it this way. So ln, just because this solution manual did it this way. So 1 over n squared. Yeah, so this is this whole thing right there, starting from n equals 2. This equals 2, and in our case, we'll use k. So now we're going to throw that inside. So up to k, starting from n equals to 2 of ln, and ln per bracket, n minus 1 over n minus ln n over n plus 1. And again, you could see that this is telescoping sum because notice here is n minus 1 over n, and then there's a minus sign, so you always need the minus sign to cancel things out. And now each one of these terms, n minus 1 plus 1 is n, and then this n plus 1 is n plus 1. So these are one larger than this. So obviously we're going to have a telescoping sum here. And this, of course, is for k is greater than, I'll just put it here, this is for k is greater than or equal to 2. All right, so that's what we have, because it's, n is 2 is the starting point. Let's put this a bit neater. For k is greater than or equal to 2. All right, so now what we have is sk is equal to, so that's the sk there. Yeah, and let's just expand this all out. So this sk is equal to ln 2, so ln 2 minus 1 is equal to 1 over 2. So when n equals to 2. Yeah, so ln sk is the first term is when n equals to 2. So 2 minus 1 is 1, and then 2 there. Subtracted by ln of 2, and then n plus 1 is, 2 plus 1, so 3. And put this bracket, and then the next term is the n equals to 3. So ln, put a bracket first. Ln, and then 3 minus 1 is 2, over n is 3, like that. Subtracted by, and then the next one is ln 3 over n plus 1, or 3 plus 1 is 4. And again, there's a cancellation right here, cancellation here. And then we keep doing this on and on, so do the next one here. Yeah, and just the next one is for n equals to 4, so plus, not equal, plus, put it here, plus ln of 4. So 4 minus 1 is 3 over 4, n is 4, minus ln 4 over n plus 1 is 4 plus 1 is 5. And then this cancels with this. And then plus dot 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 plus, then we have all the way until ln of n minus 1 over n plus, minus. This is going to be minus, this is up to the k. Up to k, all the way to k, and then k minus 1 minus ln, where n is k, k over k plus 1, like that. And then this one eventually will cancel, and this ln 4 will cancel. All we're left with is this and this. So this all equals 2 ln of 1 half ln 1 over 2 minus ln k over k plus 1. All right, so put the arrow here. So sk is equal to this and box this out. All right, so thus, put this all together, we have the summation up to infinity from n equals to 2 of ln 1 plus 1 over n squared. I mean, actually it's minus. It's going back here, it's a minus, not a plus. It's a minus, is equal to the limit as the kth partial sum goes to infinity. K goes to infinity of sk, this equals to the limit as k approaches infinity of we have here ln 1 half, ln 1 half, and then minus ln, and then where, just put k like this, k over k plus 1. And now we're going to do here, and just put a stop like that. And what I'm going to do actually, again, just to get rid of this k stuff, and because we're going to take a limit, I'm going to multiply this by 1 over k on both sides, or just on top and bottom, I mean, of this ln right here, 1 over k over 1 over k, like that. And just put this bracket here. It just saves some time. So now this all equals 2, move the ln 1 half out of there. So it equals ln 1 half minus limit as k approaches infinity of, this is going to be ln, divide this out there, so it's going to be a 1, so 1, k divided by k is 1, and then we'll have this, k divided by k is 1, and then plus 1 over k, and this becomes 1 over 1 plus 1 over k. Like that. Yeah, so that's what we have there. And then this part right here, this approaches, 1 over infinity approaches 0. So in other words, this whole thing equals to ln 1 half, or actually you could use a log rule. We'll put it over here then. So then this part right here equals to, using log rule. Well, again, we already knew this log rule. So 1 over 2, 1 divided by 2 equals the same thing as subtraction. So ln 1 minus ln 2, and then this one over here becomes, limit is going to be just 1 over, or I forget the ln. So just move that over there, put a ln there. So this becomes ln of 1 over 1 minus, 1 minus, 1 plus, 1 divided by 1 plus 0. So that's just ln 1. So that's just equals to ln 1. This cancels with this. And then this whole thing is equal to, equals to negative ln 2. And there is our sum. So that is absolutely fascinating. So we're asked to solve for the sum of this one. And we get this negative ln 2, which is quite fascinating.